杨贵妃 was called Yang Yuhuan. The romantic story between she and Tang Xuanzong was remembered by generation and generation. Yang Yuhuan was born in 719. She spent her childhood with three sisters in Yongle. When Yang Yuhuan was about 10 years old, her father passed away. Then she was raised by her uncle and moved to Luoyang. As a noble family girl, Yang Yuhuan was well educated. She had talents in dancing and playing pipa. Pipa is a traditional ancient Chinese string instrument. Now, one of Yang Yuhuan's five strings pipa was kept in Japanese museum. This pipa was a gift from Tang Xuanzong and Yang Yuhuan to Japanese emperor. When Yang Yuhuan was 15 years old, she was invited to the wedding ceremony of Princess Xian Yi, who was the daughter of Xuanzong and the consort Wu Hui. In this wedding ceremony, Princess Xian Yi's full brother, Prince So, fell in love with Yang Yuhuan at first sight. The consort Wu Hui also liked this beautiful girl, and her mother also was from Yang clan. So the consort Wu Hui happily agreed this marriage. Later of the same year, Yang Yuhuan was married with the Prince So. They spent a happy life for 3 years. Then everything was changed. In 737, the consort Wu Hui passed away. Because she was Xuanzong's favorite woman, Xuanzong felt desperate for her death. But don't worry about Xuanzong, because he was attracted by Yang Yuhuan and quickly moved on. Although Xuanzong wanted Yang Yuhuan came into the inner court immediately, but Yang Yuhuan was his daughter-in-law. She must get rid of her marriage with Prince Shou first. After carefully consideration, Xuanzong had a splendid solution. In 740, Xuanzong arranged Yang Yuhuan to be a nun in an imperial temple located in the imperial palace, using the excuse that Yang Yuhuan voluntarily prayed for Xuanzong's biological mother, who was killed by Wu Zetian. 5 years later, Xuanzong arranged a new marriage for Prince So. Then Yang Yuhuan officially became Xuanzong's noble consort, Yang Guifei. Although Xuanzong had lots of imperial women, but Yang Guifei quickly became his favorite one. Not only because Yang Guifei was extremely beautiful, but also they had the same interests. Xuanzong also had talents on music. They together composed Ni Shang Yu Yi Qu, colored seduction songs. Yang Guifei also created a matched dance. People said this dance was so amazing and only could be seen in heaven. Xuanzong really enjoyed spending time with Yang Guifei, so he spent more and more time with her. Eventually, he totally forgot his responsibilities as an emperor and spent all time with Yang Guifei. To please 杨贵妃，玄宗 give her an extremely luxury life. 玄宗 hired over 700 experienced embroiderers to make clothes for 杨贵妃, and also hired hundreds of craftsmen to make jewelries for her. 杨贵妃 loved eating lychee, but this fruit grows in the cities hundreds miles away from the capital. To keep lychees fresh, 玄宗 sent many officers to deliver lychees riding rapid military horses. During this process, many horses died. Well, usually, those horses only were used to send urgent military message between the capital and other cities. 玄宗's favor also brought huge benefits to 杨贵妃's family. All three sisters of 杨贵妃 got noble titles. 杨贵妃's cousin, 杨国忠, became high-rank government officer and later controlled the court as prime minister. Because 玄宗 satisfied what 杨贵妃 asked, more and more officers got promotion through bribing 杨贵妃 and her family members. So, Yang clan quickly collected huge amount of treasures by selling government positions. With the favor of 玄宗, Yang clan members spent a luxury life for 10 years.Until 安禄山 rebellion happened. 安禄山 was a general and a military governor of the frontier districts. He well known how to please 玄宗. 安禄山 sent lots of valuable gifts to 杨贵妃 and asked 杨贵妃 to adopt him as son. 杨贵妃 did.Although she was 20 years younger than 安禄山. Depending on the unusual relationship with 杨贵妃, 安禄山 finally was fully trusted by 玄宗 and was allowed to own a strong army. However, 安禄山 was too greedy to be satisfied by this little power.He wanted to become the emperor. With 安禄山's army became stronger and stronger, and the central government became weaker and weaker. In 755, 安禄山 launched a rebellion and quickly conquered many cities. When rebellion armies came near the capital,玄宗 with royal family members and Yang family members escaped towards Shu. It was a very hard journey. When they arrived Ma Wei Po, Tang soldiers killed Yang Guo Zhong and forced 玄宗 to kill 杨贵妃, just in case 杨贵妃's revenge. To keep his safety,玄宗 agreed soldiers' request. 杨贵妃 hung herself and passed away at 38. Personally, I think 杨贵妃 really liked France Queen Marie. We can't say Tang's collapse is all 杨贵妃's fault, but she wasn't totally innocent.Just like what said in the book, she was still too young to know that life never gives anything for nothing, and that a price is always exacted for what fate bestows. Thank you for watching this video. See you later.